extra squiggle top. I'm going to chomp on those chippies because I don't have to compete, and nor do you. But we will get a certain amount of sadistic satisfaction putting 36 supreme world-class athletes through their paces. Oh, incidentally, there's a Kiwi-Aussie clash this year too. More on that in a moment. In the meantime, let's meet our 36 lean, mean clash machines.
Defending champions, ECNZ Rowing. They are Ian Wright, Brenda Lawson, and Rob Hamill. Shall rugby consist of Ant Thrawn, Louisa Wall, and Paul Henderson? Ansett New Zealand Soccer feature Darren McLennan, Sasha Haskell, and Roger Gray. Kodak Express Swimming, Trent Bray, Philippa Langrell, and Nick Tung. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon are back too. Rick Wells, Sarah Harrow, and Hamish Carter. Line 7 Yachting, Leah Newbold, Barry Mackay, and Hamish Pepper. Reebok Aerobics will be strong again too. Arlene Thomas, Mike McSweeney, and Jason Tipatu. Smoke-free basketball netball feature Daryl Johnson, Brendan Pongia, and Sandra Edge. Stamina Athletics have in their team Mark Hutchinson, Joanne Henry, and Phil Claude. Avanti Cycling feature Mark Rendell, John Hume, and Sarah Alma. Mitsubishi Trucks League will show off the talents of Kerry Lee Rupati, Logan Edwards, and Fetu Taiwa. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving, a new team to clash this year, Ian Ferguson, Anna Ballara, and Paul Bethel.
Righto, well, you've met the athletes, now meet the man that devised the events, Paul McDonald. How are you, mate?
Simon, good to see you again.
It's nice to see you, and can I say, Mackie, you fill out your lycra beautifully, and I'm talking about your top half, don't get excited.
Oh, okay, thank you, and thank you for noticing.
So what's the story then with this series?
This is a beauty. We go for 10 weeks. At the end of 8 weeks, 6 teams out of the competition. We go through to the semi-finals, 4 teams make it through to the final. At the end of that, one of them can put their name on this.
And I believe too there's a Kiwi-Aussie clash?
Oh yeah, I'm excited about this one. We're going to pick the top 6 New Zealanders. They will come up against 6 Aussies from across the ditch. It's the Aussie-Kiwi clash.
There'll be no waltzing Matildas, so what action can you expect to see? Well, have a look at this. As you can see, plenty of action to come, but right now we're on Auckland's west coast for our first event of Clash of the Code, series number 3, and what have you called it?
Welcome to the Body Breaker.
He's a sicko. So how does it work?
Oh, it's a toughie. It's a big one.
Well, that surprises me.
It begins with a staggered start.
When all 3 reach the canoe, they'll already be feeling the pinch. It's a long paddle around the lake and then back to the edge. When they leave their canoe, it's a run through the stream, but Hal Hill will really sort them out. Their legs will be jelly. The pace will pick up down the other side for them, and then they're onto their mountain bikes. They ride through the stream, soft sand, hard sand, and back onto the road.
Back into the stream after leaving the road for a final time, and they drop their bikes in. Hey, it wouldn't be the same unless we finished it with just a short climb up the sand dune.
And he says it all, doesn't he, with this slightly maniacal look on his face. But as we say on Clash, start 'em easy. Start 'em easy. So I'm going to go and find out how the athletes feel about this first event. If you wouldn't mind giving me a wee hand down here, Paul.
Pleasure, Simon. I'll give you help.
Good as gold. I'm quite macho. Good legs! Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa! What about this particular event? Are you feeling quite comfortable with it?
Yep, I'm pretty sharp. Our whole team is actually Simon, and looking forward to a good event.
And you think you may take out this series? I mean, there's some money on you guys, you know.
Yeah, I'm not sure if we'll take it out. We'll be trying our hardest, but it's a new year, and we're still wearing pink, so we've got something to prove, eh?
Well, now, this is nice, isn't it? A team spirit, you know, two different team members, Sarah and Philippa, and you're having a little bit of chat about the series?
Well, we don't want to give away too many trade secrets.
Okay, so what have you been saying to Philippa, Sarah?
I've just been telling her to run in the deep sand. And
you've been gossiping about the boys, haven't you, Sarah? You've missed the point of this show. So who's the team leader in your team?
Oh, me, of course, yes.
And are you giving your teammates any advice on how to go?
Yeah, go hard, all the way.
Event number one, the Body Breaker, is next. Welcome back. This is event number one on the card of Clash of the Codes. It's as ugly as a handful of spiders, so let's do it. This is the Body Breaker.
Look at this. It's the usual story with Clash of the Codes, event number one. They've been building up for this for weeks, and they are screaming right from the start. Well, their thighs will be screaming halfway through this run.
Joanne Henry is scorching that sand. First to the canoe. Kerry Lee Rupati too makes a good fist of it, getting away nicely.
Now this is where it gets tricky. The team has to drag the canoe down to the water's edge and get in. Chaos, all of them arriving at once. We're going to see who's first away in just a second.
Difficult to pick.
There we have it. Surf Lifesaving grabbing the lead from League, rowing and triathlon. That's your top four. Now you can see the timing there. That's what's going to sort it out for a team. This is no timing.
That's a bit harsh, mate, early on, isn't it?
Hey, chaos around the boys for the rest of the teams, but who's got the lead? Surf Lifesaving extending it out from rowing.
Daryl Johnson from basketball netball. His legs go all the way to his neck, and he's having trouble keeping them in the boat.
Now, you might ask why Ferg's in the Lifesaving team, Simon. He was picking up national titles before you were born.
Geez, he must be old.
Rowing in second place, Rob Hamill leading that team.
Once again, expect rowing to be very strong, and this team too, triathlon, all three together. All right, let's cut to the chase, Paul. Who are you picking for this event?
Well, you haven't seen much of them yet. They're right there. I'm picking the cycling team. There is a long way to go in this race, and I think they'll come through with a win.
The man there, Rob Hamill, is a very fit champ.
Oh, and ever so gutsy, he is current world record holder on the erg.
The what?
The rowing machine, Simon.
Yeah, I know the old rowing machine, mate.
Now, am I right in saying that's Hal Hill?
Oh, it is, and it's a biggie. Ferg's still got the lead, but he doesn't know what's about to hit him. Triathlon Rick Wells making a move for his team. And here they go, Hal Hill, she's straight down onto the hands.
Rob Hamill overtaking Ann Ferguson, followed closely by Paul Bethel.
Further back in the field, they're already feeling the pinch. Wet running shoes, dry sand, hey, it's just not a good mix.
As they approach the top, Rob Hamill and Hamish Carter's made some great ground. In fact, he is going to take the lead, a man that has a ticker the size of a rock melon.
Ian Ferguson led by Paul Bethel. Ferg has dropped from first to fourth. Moving backwards, Ferg. Well, this is how you move forwards. Hamish Carter has really picked up the pace. He's first onto the bike.
...23-year-old Hamish Carter, third best in the world at triathlon, and leading handsomely.
Rob Hamill's second away. Now this is where it gets tough. If you go slow, if you find the wrong bit of sand in this wet stuff, your tyres just sink in. Now here's our leading woman, surf lifeguard Anna Ballara, holds the New Zealand record for most gold medals won at the national championships.
One more than you, I believe, Macca.
Hey, that'll be a sore point.
This is our leader, Hamish Carter, as he hits the road.
Go, go.
Watch him pick up the speed here. Go, Hamish. Oh, a change in the women's race. Sarah Harrow from Triathlon takes it from Anna Ballara. The Pinks are dominating.
Rob Hamill second in the overall competition, followed very, very closely by Rick Wells from Triathlon, and Anne Ferguson still holding fourth.
Oh, you know, this is frustrating. You just pick up the pace and it's into the water and it slows you down every time.
Hamish Carter doesn't look like he's slowing down. He is hydroplaning.
Well, tell you what, he should look out for the chasing group. Rob Hamill, Rick Wells and world-class mountain biker making a move, John Hume.
They've got some serious spade work to do, though, if they're to catch this man.
Yep, Hamish Carter onto the last leg, up the hill and a run to the finish line. The race for fifth, Ferg still hanging in there.
Mark Rendell close behind, though.
And Phil Clug, well, watch out for him on the run. 100 metres to go for Hamish, but we have a doozy of a race for second place. John Hume and Rick Wells, Rob Hamill tucked right in behind them.
John Hume then second to the bike drop.
Rick Wells in third, run still to come, anything could happen.
Mark Rendell putting in a fine effort too for the cycling team, and there is Anne Ferguson.
Oh, look at this, do you think he's happy?
He is stoked. Well done, Hamish Carter, winner of our body breaker.
That's the individual race sewn up. The question now is which team will win this event?
Sarah Harrow is making it look good for triathlon, leading woman at this stage.
Surf life-saving, triathlon, cycling, they're all there. It's going to be close. Second place, John Hume. Good stuff.
You picked it right, Mackie. You said the cyclists would do well. This is Rick Wells finishing third, 1-3 for triathlon.
Yeah, well, it's 2-4 for cycling. It's down to Sarah Harrow versus Sarah Ulmer to decide the race.
And look at this for fifth place, Phil Clode and Rob Hamill. Phil Clode, a big sprinter finish.
Hey, and do you think Rob's tired?
Have a seat, Rob.
Oh yes, woman's win to Sarah Harrow. Good on you. That's got to be good for triathlon.
Well, the results have come through. It's official after event number one. The triathletes are leading the series.
Yeah!
Oh, very coordinated. So you've sort of set a precedent here, haven't you, Hamie? You're flat out now?
Yeah, we just wanted a good start and yeah, we're just going to continue from this race and have a bit of fun.
19 events to come, Sarah. You can cope with that?
Yeah, I think we can. I think we'll start off well and we'll keep it up.
And Rico, your advice to the other teams then after this?
Oh, just get to know our backs well.
Big call!
This then is how they stack up after event number one. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon making their intentions clear, 12 points. Avanti Cycling on 11. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving have 10 points. ECNZ Rowing 9 points. Stamina Athletics, good finish for them on 8. And Kodak Express Swimming with 7 points. Reebok Aerobics on 6. And Set New Zealand Soccer have 5 points. Mitsubishi Trucks League 4 points. And doing better at this stage than they were last year. Line 7 Yachting have 3. Shell Rugby with just 2 points. And Smoke Free Basketball Netball on one.
Whoa, Macca, whoa.
Hey, you know, the only thing worse than sand in your sandwiches is sand in your underwear. We've had a bit of both today. Still, we've made it through to Auckland's east coast. This is Long Bay for the next event. So how does it work, Paul?
I love this one. One athlete starts up the beach as two teammates, down with the boat. All three in the boat, they race around an M-shaped course, come back to the kill line, kill the motor, lift it up, get the boat back to the shoreline, take the motor off, take the strop off, disconnect the fuel line, carry the boat to the finish line. She's two heats in a final, first three into the final.
Piece of cake, and the athletes are fired up about this baby.
I'm thinking this one looks much better than the last one.
Pretty daunting, wasn't it? So what about the water? Are you a water person?
I was when I was younger. Yeah, I'm sure I'll get it back really quickly.
Well, I really think we've got to go for the stranglehold on this one, and we're going to have to take it out from the start. And, you know, not we can't pussyfoot around. You know.
Where do you normally spend most of your time in the surf then?
Oh, swimming.
Right.
Swimming. Yep. Out in the boards and skis, but definitely not in the rubber duckies.
You're like the Baywatch team with the little wee red things hanging off you. Is that
no,
right?
No, not likely.
You'd be a water man, wouldn't you?
Yeah, in a tub.
You like a bit of water in the tub?
Yeah, not too much, but I can't see at the bottom. Scared of the bottom.
Well, the athletes have been drilled, and I feel a rescue coming on. The IRB rescue is next. Stay with us. Welcome back. You know, in some circles, IRB stands for incredibly raucous behaviour. In fact, the same could be said for this occasion. But down to the serious bizzo, we are rescuing, and here we go.
Inshore rescue boats, actually, Simon, and in Heat 1 we have yachting, basketball, netball, swimming, cycling, athletics and aerobics.
Gorgeous day for racing as they hit the surf. Oh, I think Phil Clode might have hurt himself there.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's helped his team off to a very quick start. Athletics in front, swimming in second.
You'll notice too the athletes for this event are driving the boats themselves. But do they actually rescue anyone, Paul?
No, they don't, but these machines are rescue machines.
Around the boy, they look very skillful. Have they had some sort of tuition?
Oh, they've been getting some help, but it's just all go for these guys. They sort it out very quickly, even down to the body position. Inside the swimming team boat, oh, look at this, all concentration.
Athletics still have the lead. The motor goes up. Now this is a crucial part of the race.
It is. They must have that motor coming up out of the water before that line. It's in, take the motor off the boat and carry the boat up the beach. That is where the race is going to be won and lost.
In come the yachties. A real scramble here. And the lead has changed.
Yep, cycling out in front. That's a turn up for the books. Yeah, you can't say they've got a great carrying technique, but Sarah Ulmer, John Hume and Mark Rendell take it out. They will be joined in the final by swimming and athletics.
Right, going, John. You must have been steaming there, mate.
Steaming, we're smoking. Great smoking all the way.
Heat 2, the first three into the final. Rugby, triathlon, league, soccer, rowing and surf lifesaving.
How crucial is it to get away to a flyer here?
Well, I like to lead a race from the start. This is not what triathlon is doing. Bad getaway from them.
But the experts, surf lifesaving, lead around boy 2.
Oh, look at that style. Low body position, no wind resistance. They're going great guns.
Paul Bethel, the driver, good Canterbury man that.
And past New Zealand team captain and the most capped New Zealand surf lifeguard ever.
Good qualifications, they are leading and very comfortably too. Roger Gray controlling the soccer team, second spot for them.
Coming into the beach, psyching up for the drop of the motor. Whoa, he's pulling up a little bit early. That's not in the race plan. That's going to give a little gap for the other teams.
Rick Wells controlling traffic. Ow, hello!
Oh, bad move by the lead team. They stopped way too late. That's going to cost them a penalty.
Soccer team struggling with their motor.
Now this is how you carry a boat. Very easy one for surf life saving. Soccer grabs second, league will take third and rugby fourth, but by the time we add up the penalties, rugby make it through to the final.
Paul, you look like you were pretty happy there.
Yeah, mate, I enjoyed that. It's good fun.
And Ferg, you got away to a good run?
For me, yeah.
For an old guy.
For an old guy.
Well, I got bowled at the end, though, by the other boat.
Oh, bit of tension for the final. Surf lifesaving in lane 1, athletics in 2, cycling, swimming, soccer and rugby in lane 6.
Athletics, as you'd expect, good runners, straight into the boat first.
Now you'd have to have your money on surf lifesaving here, but terrible start from them. That's going to give a break for a few of the other teams.
Athletics like the first heat leading, but very close, swimming in second.
And a boy, 1-0 between these two boats.
Round they go, very, very tight.
Swimming have got first, athletics second, it looks like cycling in third. Yes it is, rugby in fourth, and whoa, way back in fifth, surf life saving.
Good technique. Look at the rugby team straight into the surf lifesavers. That may cost them. And dearly.
The swimming team with Trent Bray driving are absolutely creaming it first into the beach. Cycling have grabbed second, athletics in third.
Rugby coming in, Lewisa Wall jumping out. Oh, she tried to put the big hit on the boat and the boat won.
Here comes surf lifesaving. Bad race for them way back in fifth. First off with the motor, it's cycling well out in front. Sort out that technique, team.
Cycling leading, this could be a big win for them.
Athletics in second, surf lifesaving in third. Oh, surf are moving fast, good technique, they've grabbed second.
And that could be the break they look for. Surf lifesaving may take the cyclists right at the death now. It is neck and neck. It is going to be surf lifesaving by a fraction.
Big win for them. This is how they came in then. Surf lifesaving took it out. Cycling in second, athletics in third, followed by swimming, rugby and soccer in sixth. League were followed by rowing, yachting in ninth, triathlon 10th, basketball, netball and aerobics.
You must have cut that so fine.
We need to make it look exciting.
This week's racing then is over, and this is how the teams stack up. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving with a first and a third from today have 22 points, tied with Avanti Cycling. Stamina Athletics have 18. Kodak Express Swimming, good performance today, 16 points. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon on 15. And ECNZ Rowing, last year's champions, have 14 points, pretty well placed. NSET New Zealand Soccer on 12. Shell Rugby, look at this battle. Shell Rugby tied with Mitsubishi Trucks League 10 apiece. Line 7 Yachting have 7. They are tied with Reebok Aerobics, who came second last year, 7 each. And finally, smoke-free basketball netball on 3.
Well, you can certainly tell Clash of the Codes is back, because I feel absolutely clapped out and I was just talking. But a big day, mate.
Oh, huge day, Simon. First event, real toughie for everyone. Second event here with the IRB Rescue. Nearly a huge upset. Surf lifesaving just coming through on the line.
And next week, it doesn't get any easier. The big wheels keep on turning and the big legs keep on burning.
Yes, sir. What would Clash be without the human trotting? We fire up the nags and then throw our backs into it. The big rigs in the track pool.
Well, I can't wait for next week. I'm going to see you then.
Absolutely. Hope you can join us next week right here on Clash of the Codes. Hooroo. Hey there, and welcome to Clash of the Codes. This is week number 2 as we put the wheels into motion on the big rigs a little bit later on and harness up the fillies at beautiful Alexandra Park. Although Anstrawn probably doesn't appreciate being called a filly. He doesn't mind horse, it's filly he has a problem with. You know, on Cup Day, they race for a purse of up to $500,000 here. Today, though, the stakes are a happy Jose Pie and pride. Oh, and Ant wants that purse we talked about. But first things first, cast your mind back to last week when we hit the sand dunes and blew up the inflatables.
And boy, did we hit those sand dunes in the body breaker. Very hot day, very hot action. A bit of running, a bit of a paddle, a lot of sweat, and the odd tear or two as well. Surf Lifesaving looked very comfortable at the start of the race. Ferg was right out there leading the way. Rick Wells had a good run, but this is the hill that got them all. Hell Hill. And it lived up to its name. In fact, that's where this man, Hamish Carter, took the lead, and he wasn't going to let it go, supported all the way by teammate Sarah Harrow. Together, they had a great win for the triathletes. The IRB rescue was up next. It was fast, it was furious, and it was flat out on the water. The swimmers in the final looked very comfortable for most of the way, and surprisingly, Surf Lifesaving, you see them being edged out by the rugby team, struggled. The drag of the boat was all important. The cyclists thought they had it, but coming from nowhere, Surf Lifesaving took the win. So the Clash of the Codes leaderboard after week one. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving tied with Avanti Cycling, 22 apiece. Stamina Athletics, great work for them, 18 points. Kodak Express Swimming are back after a year's absence on Clash. They have 16. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon with 15 points. Back one from them, ECNZ Rowing on 14. And Set New Zealand Soccer have 12. Now this is a good battle. The All Blacks versus the Warriors, Shell Rugby, Mitsubishi Trucks League tied on 10. Line 7 Yachting also tied with Reebok Aerobics, 7 points each. And finally, Smoke-Free Basketball Netball have just 3 points at this stage.
Righto, well that's how the teams stand then after week number one. Human trotting in just a moment works very simply. Two guys pulling the woman in the sulky who's in the hot seat, as it were. Tell you more about that in just a tick. But Paul, you've introduced a new twist to Clash this year.
Dead right, Simon. Clash of the Codes is all about the team, but this year we've introduced some tests of individual excellence. We call them primes, and our first prime is the woman towing the men in the sulky over 220 metres. The winners pick up bonus points for their team. 3 points for first, 2 points for second, and 1 point for third.
You've had a test run then, Sarah?
Yeah, I have, yep.
Feeling what?
Yeah, I'm fine, feeling okay. I don't know about John there. He's the only one wearing a helmet, so I don't think he trusts me driving too much this morning.
Hey, I have faith in my mare. She's a good pony.
Do you think you'll be fairly quick over the 220 metres?
I really don't know. Well, no, in 20 seconds' time.
But you're fast up and down the court, eh?
Yeah, well, that's on the court, Simon. It's not along a racetrack with a fella behind me.
So how's the nerves in before you get into this, Philippa?
Oh, no, nerves are pretty good. Yeah. Don't call me Philly for nothing.
This is the first of our primes, then. The sulky sprint. Who is the fastest woman over 220 metres? Let's find out.
For this start, it pays to have powerful legs and a light teammate, and already, Joanne Henry, New Zealand's top heptathlete, straight out the front.
Look at those legs pumping. Great to watch. And from Clash Cam, you can see how tight it is in there. Kerry Lee Ruppati doing very well.
This is not even a race. Joanne is just flying. It's all on for second, but first, it's all over.
Lewisha Wall for rugby, second place. Joanne Henry and Phil Claude, her teammate, sitting on the back of a winner.
Oh, yeah, he looks pretty happy about it too. Oh, so easy.
Athletics take out the first of our primes. Who's it going to be for second? Lewisha Wall. And Anne Strawn from rugby takes second spot.
Photo finish for third. Anna Ballara takes it out. 1 point for Surf Lifesaving.
Awesome race.
I'm naked now.
That was incredible. You bolted away.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Awesome.
I just like coming over blocks, 100 metres. Yeah.
Turn your attention to the human trotting mark, and you're feeling what about this event?
Yeah, we talked about it. We're just going to put our legs between our tails and hoof it, mate. It's got to be done.
Better that than the other way, I guess. And of course, cyclists, you know, you're renowned for having quite strong, pumping legs, yeah?
On a bike, yeah, but not on running. I think we might lag a little bit behind, but Hopefully we'll pull one off.
Sarah, the women's job normally in this, the human trotting, is to really rack the guys up. Do you think you'll be capable of doing that?
Yeah, I think so. I think I've got the easier option here, actually, for the 600 metre one. Just run the 200 and it's not a lot of fun, I can tell you, so I'm quite happy to take a back seat in the next one.
We're a team of two different runners, so I, you know, Darren's the men for speed, fast twitch muscle group. I've got no muscles, so we'll see how we go.
And Darren, you're pretty confident you can take out something here?
Oh, I think so. I think if we're, first, second or third, we'll be happy with that.
How's the old body, mate?
Oh, the body's good. It's just we've still got an internal problem here. We're trying to, if Hamish is ahead of the horse, well, then what does that make me? And so we're trying to decide. So that's our problem.
Who do you think is maybe the most threatening-looking team out there?
Basketball.
Basketball. Well, that's high praise.
They've got pole position, see?
Have you got pole position?
We've got pole position today. We've got the Black Stallion in our team, mate, so you've got to watch the streak down the straight. He's going to be flying, mate. Daryl Johnson's going to be flying.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. Tired of coming in lab. We need one to win.
We're going
to
be riding on the rail again. Boxed in, we're going to have to work around and come down and bring it home good on the home straight.
Oh, so is there a bit of niggle? You're not happy with your draw, Haim? Is that what the problem is?
We're very just quietly, but I'm not going to say anything about that. Where's Paul?
Well, the human trotting is about to get underway, and you know, we've got right through till now without a horsey joke, and that's good. Horse walks into a bar, guy says, hey, what's with the long face? Human trotting is next. Welcome back. Well, the nags are all saddled up. 600 metres the distance, mobile start, and this heat may be a factor. Some of the horses frothing at the bit. Let's get them underway.
Yes, just jockeying for position now. Looking pretty good. In the starter's hands. And the legend from Canterbury, Logan Edwards, at the helm of the league team. It's a handicap draw. The slower teams are in the front of the grid. The faster teams, lighter teams at the back. Athletics, after that great prime, will be hot favourites for this one.
Well, they could be, but if you think back to last year, they led all the way, and this team from Triathlon came through and put them on the post.
Athletics going awfully wide, covering a lot of distance. Wow, she's aggressive, that Joanne Henry.
Once she's figured out they're covering the extra distance, she wants them in on the rail.
There they go. Rowing just nestled back with Surf Life Saving. But this team looks boxed in. Basketball netball. Could be trouble. There is trouble. They're out of it.
What a shame. That's what happens. Look at the chaos. Rowing make their move right now. Surf Life Saving will be right behind them.
League in Triathlon, well placed. Just tucked in nicely behind Athletics.
Oh, everyone's jockeying for position around this curve. They really want to be on the inside. We could see another crash.
They've got the advantage. The long legs from Athletics. Setting them up well, but I guess 300 to go.
300 to go, anything can happen. Triathlon have just moved into second. That puts League in third.
Soccer doing nicely. Darren McLennan just trying to slip the shackles. And you can see way, way back in the distance, basketball netball, ready for the glue factory.
Here's how they sit. Athletics, Triathlon, League, rowing, soccer and cycling, Surf Life Saving.
Joanne Henry, I think there is some gamesmanship going on here.
Oh, a few tactics there from Athletics. I don't think they want Triathlon to get past.
But they're giving it their best shot. It'll be a very, very close finish. Go wide, go left is the call. It is going to be tight. Athletics, Triathlon, it is Athletics.
Tight for them and tight for third. League team take it ahead of rowing, soccer in fifth.
And look at cycling. They have had it. This is exactly how tight it was. A head between first and second and just a couple of warriors between third and fourth. So close. Great race.
Just confirming those places, athletics took it out, triathlon second, league in third. Rowing, soccer and surf lifesaving in sixth. They were followed by swimming, cycling, yachting, aerobics, rugby and basketball netball.
Pretty hard work, Mark.
Very hard work towards the end there. Triathlon came at us and it was a good finish. Good fun.
Very close finish, Ricky.
Yeah, it was a bit. We just ran out of space. You know, but that's sort of the way it is. We keep them honest.
Did you think with, like, you know, 30 or 40 to go that you might peg them back?
Yeah. We're flying at the line, but they were just holding on. Yeah. Another metre or two, yeah. Might have been a different result.
So with three events down, Stamina Athletics have bolted to the lead, 33 points. McDonald Surf Lifesaving on 33 back from them, Avanti Cycling on 27. Close at hand, Sheraton Hotels Triathlon after that great finish, 26 points. ECNZ Rowing have moved up 1 to 23 and Kodak Express Swimming on 22 points. Mitsubishi Trucks League, 20 points, tied with Ansett New Zealand Soccer on 20. Shell Rugby have 14. Line 7 Yachting on 11 points. Reebok Aerobics, a shock to the system for them. They aren't well placed at this stage on 10. And Smoke-Free Basketball Netball way back on 4.
Righto, well, the teams are starting to sort themselves out now. And coming up is the track pull, quite a strength event, mate.
Oh, yes, very much so. So we thought we'd throw in a strength prime. Each team's got to pick their strongest bloke, and he's got to pick up three of these beer kegs,
yep.
Toss them over the line.
Yep.
First one with all three kegs over the line picks up three bonus points for his team.
No worries, three of these. Got his goal, let's do that now, mate. One of the bigger fellas in the series, Paul, so you must be feeling confident.
No, not really. I was actually looking around some, and there's some big chaps here, especially in the rowing.
You'd be used to doing weights in that.
Oh, yeah, I am, but not like this.
So, Mark, first of all, yourself. Now, and I say this with a great deal of respect, you don't look like you're huge in the upper body region.
No,
look at that.
Look at this.
Keep it folded.
Keep it folded, push him out.
And you're feeling okay about this one?
Yeah, but I thought that carrying kegs was for Clydesdales, and there's a few of them around, actually, so it could be tough.
Don't breathe and don't blink, because this is fast.
Paul Henderson's away, the big fella. Roger Gray doing nicely, too, on the left.
And Fitu Toa onto his third barrel, throws it at the ground. He's won it.
So calm, isn't he? Look at that.
Look at this in slow-mo. From the left of your screen, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see Fitu Toa, fourth from the left of your picture. And Paul Henderson is seventh in the yellow there. Very tight, last barrel. Look how tight this finish is.
Now that's what wins it for him, throwing the barrel at the ground. Look at the highlight, there it is, nothing between them, but pushing it down, that's what wins it for Fitu.
Did you have a particular style that you approached that event with?
Fast as I can.
And what about Logan? What did he tell you?
Go Fitu.
Well done, 3 points, that's good for the team.
Yeah, we're happy with that.
Those primes are good, mate, you know, individual brilliance, and I can relate to that.
Oh, yuck. Give me a bucket. I'm going to be sick.
So, mate, how does this track pull work? Is it the same as last year?
No, we've had a little twist, actually. This time, all athletes begin on the finish line. They run to the track, climb into the harness, and then pull 8-tonne of truck 100 metres to the finish line. Two heats, first three from each heat into the final.
Oof, that's tough.
Yeah, but before we begin, this track's a little far forward, so I'm just going to have to push it back a tad.
Leave it to me, mate. No dramas. Lois and Clark, mate, I've seen it.
Yeah, good on you, Lois.
You're machines.
Major sponsors. This is our race.
It's your race?
It's our race.
We've just heard you're at this stage. You dropped from first last week. You were leading the competition last week. This week, after the first event of the day, you're now in third place. Are you concerned at all about that, Sarah?
No, not concerned. No, I don't think so. We'll put it back in the cycling events. I think we've got John. He's a pretty good mountain biker, so they tell me. So I think he'll put it back in the mountain bike events.
And the harness is very comfortable to wear?
Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah, for the guys, maybe.
Jason, what's the sort of the plan?
That'll be giving it away, so. We've got tactics, stay low, stay tight, and just get into it. Drive it home.
It is a blistering hot day at Whenuapai Air Base. This sun and those big rigs are about to melt down the legs of our athletes. The track pull is next. Welcome back. This is heat number one of the track pull.
League, athletics, swimming, rowing, yachting and rugby, first three into the final.
Getting into the harness is going to take some work. It's not all that easy.
As long as you stay calm and work as a team, it's not a problem. It's just a little slower going back.
Certainly is slower. The rowers should do well. Big, strong.
Yeah! Come on!
Rowing is the call from Ian Wright.
You know, you'd be upset if you drew rugby or rowing in your heat. Well, they're both in here. We've got four upset teams.
This is a shot of the swimmers. Trent Bray going left, going right, going left. He's not sure. Mitsubishi Trucks League. You can see their truck in the background.
Our two race favourites are easing up. They're saving it for the final.
Save some of it.
We're sweet ass, mate, says Ant Strawn. And they might be. The rowers first across the line.
Oh, now this could be a surprise. Athletics are holding out yachting.
Rugby have second, no question. Who is going to be the other team to make the final? Athletics, they have done it ahead of yachting.
Oh, big upset.
Heat number two. Three of these teams will make the final.
Basketball, netball, surf lifesaving, soccer, aerobics, cycling and triathlon.
It'd be fair to say that two teams have to do particularly well, aerobics and basketball, netball.
Now that's how you get into a harness, fast and fast away.
Just like this team. Kind of.
Maybe.
Not really,
not at all.
Bad luck, I feel for them.
I'll tell you what, there's five other teams here who don't even care. They're glad they're doing badly here. Three teams only through to the final, and Surf Lifesaving wants to be in there.
So much technique, we've found this out from past years. Low body position, legs driving, and trying to smile at the camera.
Yeah, and just like Heat 1, I'd expect the early leaders to slow down and save their energy for the finals.
Hamish thinks he's there.
That's a perfect example of power walking, isn't it?
Triathlon are going to take out the second heat. Yes.
Good work.
Second across the line, aerobics good work from them and surf lifesaving, and no one will let up in the final.
We have our six finalists. They are on their marks and set to go.
And they are deadly serious about this one. Triathlon, rowing, surf lifesaving, aerobics, rugby and athletics.
You've got to say rowing, don't you?
Well, they're a strong team and Brenda Lawson is world champion. They've got a little advantage in this one, I'd say. Now, this team is well coordinated, always organised. Rugby, though, they're having a little bit of problem getting away here.
Six tracks on the runway of Whenuapai. And Strawn checking out the opposition.
Short steps, come on, keep it going. Pull it in there.
Started well, rugby.
That's 8 ton they're pulling. It's a lot of weight on their shoulders. These harnesses are built to take it.
Now, already athletics have surprised many people in the series and are doing very well here.
Oh, no, it's me! It's your son,
no! Mrs. Hamill, if you're watching, your son's losing it on the series.
Yeah! Yeah! We're moving!
Last year, aerobics surprised everyone and won this event. This team's doing just fine.
But look at rowing. You'd need a compass and a cup lunch to follow them. Miles ahead.
Here we go!
Oh, they are just blowing this race apart. I'm impressed. Now, there may not be much to this team. They're lightweights, but gee, they're doing well.
Rugby started out maybe too hard. The quads are burning up.
And Surf Lifesaving, bad race from them way back.
But as expected, the rowers have taken out first spot.
Oh, and big day for athletics. Second in this, first earlier on, and a prime. Oh, they'll be stoked.
And aerobics take out third place. Fourth rugby, fifth triathlon, and sixth surf lifesaving. A big day at the office.
So here's how they all came in. Rowing from athletics, aerobics in third, rugby, triathlon and surf lifesaving. Seventh was yachting, followed by cycling, basketball, netball, soccer, swimming and league.
Pretty intensive work, Rob.
Yeah, it's ugly actually. Extremely ugly.
You're a king of understatements, aren't you, Simon?
2 weeks down and eight to go, and this is how they look. Stamina Athletics is leading Clash of the Codes, 44 points. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving on 37. ECNZ Rowing gradually moving up, 35 points. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon have 34. Avanti Cycling, 32 points. And Shell Rugby have made a move too this week. They are now on 25. Kodak Express Swimming have 24, tied with Mitsubishi Trucks League on 24. Not such a flash day for them. And Set New Zealand Soccer on 23. Reebok Aerobics have 21. Fallback from them, Line 7 Yachting on 17 points. And Smoke-Free Basketball Netball trailing the field on 8 points.
Well, you have to say, don't you, Paul? Very happy for athletics to be leading at this stage.
Oh, mate, this athletics team is just superb. You've got to take your hat off to them. They're doing well, and I think they're going to do better yet.
Well, speaking of which, next week, the multidiscipline with the biathlon and the Queen Street Mile.
Yes, for once, Queen Street is all one-way traffic. Then it's off to Eden Park, where we abseil, shoot some paintballs, and shoot some hoops.
So do you reckon they can hang on, that athletics team, mate?
I certainly do. I've put a dollar each way on them already.
Let's hope so. Hope you can join us next week right here on Clash of the Cards. We'll see you then. Haru. Hey there, thanks for joining us for another week of gut-wrenching, bone-crunching disciplines on Clash of the Codes. You like that? Gut-wrenching, bone-crunching, very macho. Piece of quiche. Today on the Clash menu, we have the biathlon from right here on the hallowed turf of Eden Park. It's a privilege to be here. And later on, we pound the Queen Street pavement, all in an attempt to find the greatest sporting code in the country. But last week, boy, the athletics squad took it away with the human trotting first, and they were also very impressive with an 8-ton Mitsi truck strapped to their backs.
Yes, the sulkies were definitely not sulking. Logan Edwards and the league team got out very handsomely. Basketball netball struggled early on, but the athletics team were the big movers. Here's basketball netball. Have a look at this. Yes, Paul Bahami, sort of. There were the two favourites, athletics and triathlon, doing battle, and at the finish, athletics just by a nose. In the truck pulling event, aerobics won this event last year, so they were odds on favourite. Triathlon harnessed up very, very well. Surf Lifesaving, a very strong team, they too looked good early on. But there's the aerobics squad marching it out. Athletics, they surprised everyone. But the big winners at the end of the day were the very strong rowing team, and they deserve their win. So the Clash of the Codes leaderboard, Stamina Athletics, with four events down, they've had a first, a second, a third and a fifth, giving them 44 points. McDonald Surf Lifesaving, 7 back on 37. ECNZ Rowing, 35. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon, 1 back on 34, well placed. Avanti Cycling, 32. And Shell Rugby have 25 points. Kodak Express Swimming are on 24, tied with Mitsubishi Trucks League, also 24. Ansett New Zealand Soccer, 1 back, 23. Reebok Aerobics, remember, second in the series last year, a lot of work to do, on 21 points. Line 7 Yachting have 17, and Smoke-Free Basketball Netball saving themselves on 8.
Early days, but things are looking pretty good. What about this?
Eden Park, hello turf.
You know, there's only one place better. Lancaster Park.
Forget it, Pucko. This is the place. Don't even think about it.
So what about the prime then for today, Mike?
Well, you couldn't come to Eden Park without running from try line to try line. We want to find out the fastest man and the fastest woman, and hey, you couldn't do it here without carrying a rugby ball.
100 metre sprint, 3 points up for grabs. Let's see how the guys are feeling about this.
Hey, Daryl, you got a bit of sweat on already, mate.
Yeah, I'm ready for the sprint event. We in last at the moment, and we need this one. And this is when I feel like I can get it because it's a long sprint. I feel like I got a slow takeoff, but once I get into the stride, I'm on to it.
Joanne, you'll be used to this sort of thing with the long jump, quick start.
Oh yeah, this is looking more and more like me. Just going to be out of the box and it's short, flat and straight, so I love it.
Good stuff. Let's see your form then. Well, great weather at the park for the first prime of the day, the 100 metre sprint. You know what we have to do though, the old pitch report. That worm got a pretty rude awakening. No, things look pretty good for this prime, so let's start them up.
Set.
They're off. 100 metre dash. Joanne Henry looking very good. Kerry Lee Rookparty putting in a big effort, but it's Joanne Henry, one-way traffic. She's blitzed it. Kerry Lee and Sandra Edge fighting it out. Look at that. No one else even in the picture. Kerry Lee sneaks second. It's close for third. But here she is, the Flash.
No contest for the gold medal. Silver goes to the league team in the race for third. Sandra Edge grabs bronze.
Oh, that felt good. I can just see what JK might feel like running down there for a breakaway try now.
Take your marks. Set.
It's the men's turn then. 100 metres, same distance. Look at Darren McLennan there in the orange, getting a great start. And Strawn and Logan Edwards. Now there's a battle on Eden Park, but it's Darren McLennan from the soccer team. Easy winner. What a race maker.
Oh, this is sacrilege on the park. Soccer take it out. Lee grabs second, and the best rugby can do is third on their home turf. Lord,
it's like swearing in church.
Did you think maybe you're going to do that well?
Oh, I thought I'd be up in the top three, but bit of a bonus, I think, coming first.
3 points bonus, two.
That's the one.
Here we go, the Clash Biathlon. Now, bear with me, Simon, this is a complex one.
All right, mate.
Begins with a sprint down the park, basketball hoops, shoot through those, four paintball targets to be hit, and it's down the ground, kicking the old rugby ball between the posts. It's a team relay, woman second, final man in the team. When all three have completed the course, we have a winner. There's a twist, though. It begins with a sprint down the park, pass the old ball up the stands, and an abseil to get back in here.
Sweet event. Now, listen, mate, I'm getting a bit of a tingle being at Eden Park. I wonder if you could just pretend house is packed, Sai gets the ball, the old Sai Meister scores, okay?
I'll be with you on this one, man. Easy pass.
Step, swerve, fend, Jonah Lomu, dive in.
Oh, yes, nice try, Simon. Auckland 40, Canterbury 5, Auckland take it.
Oh, no, don't. Please don't. No.
You don't want us to show that?
No.
You look a bit nervous, Ant.
Yeah, it's not too good, but Mrs. Henderson's out there shooting basketball, so someone had to do it.
Climbing on the ball.
Dad would be ashamed.
Having a bit of a job strapping yourself in there, Nick.
Pull it out over your.
No, well, I'm just getting the grips of it.
It's a bit tight around. It's like nappies, really. I feel like a smaller version of a sumo wrestler strapping on one of these things.
I'm going to stand back. It might fly off at any angle.
Oh, yeah. Righto, well, the athletes have been primed, so let's not hang about. The Clash Biathlon, in a moment. Righto, mate, I think they'll believe that.
Right,
cheers, Ed. Good on you, boy. Oh, hello. Yeah.
Welcome back. Now, not that I pretend to know a tremendous amount about multidiscipline events, but I would suggest maybe calm nerves and a steady hand will win on the day. Let's see how the guys get on.
You're not too far off the mark, actually, Simon. A sprint to begin with, then a throw of the ball up into the grandstand to their teammate. Hey, as soon as your heater goes, these guys just go hell for leather.
Logan Edwards with a good pass. So too Darren McLennan. I guess the ball skills teams will do very well here.
Well, you'd hope, but time will tell. Soccer away with a good lead, up to the top of the stand, and soccer's away in the abseil.
Roger Gray, look at him go down. And Hamish Pepper, not worried about their manhood. Roger Gray kicking out, nice form.
Now watch Brendan Pongia come down straight onto its backside. Now they're into the park, it's a sprint down to the other end and off to the basketball shoot.
Fetu Taiwa from Rugby League, the Warriors. Leading the way, Hamish Pepper second, Hamish Carter third.
Straight to the ball, come on Fetu, show us your style.
Hamish has got style to burn, he's off. The Yachties are leading for the first time in the series.
Very close, triathlon aerobics both off to the paintball shoot. Let's check out their form here.
Hamish, one eye closed, one eye open. Doesn't work.
Does two.
Does three.
One more and he's away.
Gone.
That guy is one talented athlete. Few of the others though are struggling.
Fetu Tai was still, no, he's got it.
Now this is good shooting form from Ferg, another style from Hamish Carter. And Fetu, well, stuck on four.
Can't get it. Roger Gray with an interesting technique, he's away too, but there's our leader, Hamish Pepper, followed by Mike McSweeney.
Ian Ferguson in third, Hamish, pressure is on, hold the lead, mate. Oh, that's a miss. Oh, beautiful, straight over the black dot,
as they say in the classics. Ian Ferguson, no. Mike McSweeney has a crack and he's away.
No, Ferg. Strawny, how can you do? Oh, doesn't look good, but it's over. Leah Newbold, first away for the yachting team. She will have to do the same three disciplines as what the men just did.
Mike McSweeney tags Arlene Thomas, New Zealand aerobics champion.
Oh, good form, Fetu. Oh, he missed. Oh, that's two outside. I don't believe this.
Go, Fetu. John Marnie won't want you, mate. Leah Newbold then, shooting the hoops.
Yachting from aerobics, great lead. And she's just extended it.
Fetu's finally got one over, sets off Kerry Lee Rupati.
Oh, Sandra Edge straight in, she'll be away first time, no sweat. Sorry I spoke, Sandra.
The old commentator's curse. Anna Ballara trying her best to slot one. Next to her, Brenda Lawson.
Oh, that's good form from Arlene Thomas. She's just got to hit the target, that's all. Look at this, Deadeye Lou onto target four. Rugby grab the lead.
Philippa Langrell's away too.
Well, here's second and third. Basketball, netball and soccer. All
right. Anxious.
Make sure it goes over, Lou Baby.
Lou Baby is the call. Make sure it goes over. No worries.
Too easy.
Oops.
Oh, look at that from Sandra Edge straight over. And Sasha Haskell, she never misses.
Lewis is away now too.
Basketball, netball take the lead for the first time in Clash of the Codes third series.
Darren McLennan pretty close second. And Paul Henderson, Ginge from Southland, is away.
Two of the women at the back of the field, they're happy, got those basketballs in. Now this will be easy.
DJ. Swish.
Hey, nothing but net.
Up the backboard, over the grass, to the guns.
Hey, can I play?
No.
Oh, Sarah Harrow is still having trouble with that ball.
Yes, it hasn't got much better since rehearsal. Joanne Henry punts it over and she's off.
Here we go at the guns. DJ is having a little trouble. Paul Henderson and Darren McLennan right in behind him.
Darren, good technique. Steady as a rock.
On to Daryl Johnson's target. He is not having a good time. Only up to the second hit.
Paul Henderson needs the four. He's got it. He's off.
Rugby grab the lead on Eden Park. There will be a ton of pressure on Paul Henderson to get this goal kick over.
Daryl Johnson. He looks like he's away. He is away. That's good for basketball netball.
And look at the speed of Darren McLennan. He's going to nail his kick first time. So, Paul, we've got our fingers crossed for you.
Paul Henderson, a southern man. No dramas as he slots it between the uprights.
And Darren McLennan rushes and misses. Oh, look at this. The rugby team links up. Is this a win for them on Eden Park or what?
I think so, says Ed Strawn. Well done, rugby.
Soccer, second place. Good finish for them too.
Well done, guys.
Good stuff.
Last year's champions in the Clash Biathlon, basketball, netball, grabbed third. So this is how they all came in then. Rugby took it out from soccer and basketball, netball. Fourth was rowing, fifth athletics from league. Seventh was triathlon, aerobics, eighth yachting, surf lifesaving, cycling, and last was swimming.
Great finish, rugby, eh?
Oh, magnificent, yeah. Eden Park, of course, so
we had to win on here.
Fantastic, and Ant, you wouldn't be used to winning on Eden Park, mate.
Well, yeah, that's true there, mate, but hey, we needed a win and we got up. It was good.
Good stuff. So the overall standings then. Stamina Athletics have extended their lead, 55 points. ECNZ Rowing have moved up one to take second on 44. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving have 40. That tied with Sheraton Hotels Triathlon also on 40. Shell Rugby with that first place have moved to 38 points. And Ansett New Zealand Soccer one back on 37. Mitsubishi Trucks League have 35. Avanti Cycling have dropped from 5th to 8th place on 34 points. Reebok Aerobics 26. Kodak Express Swimming dropped a bit too on 25. Line 7 Yachting at 21 points. And Smoke-Free Basketball Netball 19 points. Ant Strawn, what do you think of this series so far?
Well, they're about to close Queen Street for our Queen Street Mile, and I guess, Paul, it's going to be a pretty hard race.
Oh, it is, and it's a very complex one. Start up there, finish way down there.
In between a heck of a lot of pain.
Oh, this is a hell race. You just watch those legs turn to jelly from halfway on.
And I guess you're picking Hamish Carter again. He won it last year.
No, I'm not. No, I'm picking Phil Clode.
You're a brave man. Incidentally, so am I, because we're standing in the middle of the road and they haven't closed it yet. Here's what the athletes have to say about this event.
Are aerobic champions good runners?
Whoa. I can't speak for the rest of them, but I'm sure some of them are. Me, I don't really pursue the running thing.
Hamish, you won it last year. Just pipped, I believe it was John Campbell, didn't you?
Yeah.
From athletics.
Yeah, that's right.
So how are you feeling now?
I'm not sure. Phil's a lot faster than that. He can probably run about as fast as I can ride my bike, so I got my work cut out.
No, man.
This boy can run. He can really run.
I'm feeling pretty confident, really, being it. I'm going to stay behind Hamish Carter, you know, let him set the pace and I'll just follow. And then I'm going to try to take him at the end.
Philippa, you've obviously spent a lot of time in the pool, but not so much running?
Not a lot of running, sorry. No, the physios reckon I should stick to the water, I think.
Very interesting training technique that, Joanne.
Oh, you caught me at it, Simon.
Well, now, the race is just about to go, and as you can see, the athletes are warming up. Yes, their legs were made for running. Mine were made for... Just forget about that bit. The Queen Street Mile is next. See you in a mo. Welcome back. Well, you know, there's something about running a mile that sets hearts a-fluttering. So who are you picking to take this one out? Well, let's see if you're right. Athlete set.
Nearly 1,600 metres down Auckland's main street. It's almost all downhill and it is just hell on the body.
Athletics are leading Phil Clode and they say they may go 1 and 2 in this one.
Well, give it another 3.5 minutes and you'll know. Phil Clode at the moment out in front from Hamish Carter.
The bunch sorting themselves out. Is there a strategy they follow?
Oh yeah, bit of swerving going on there, and you can see everyone trying to draft behind Phil.
You sound like you know what you're talking about there, Macca. Phil Clode, Hamish Carter and Mark Hutchinson, the leading three.
Coming to the end of the real steep bit, this is where the pace will start to pick up. Leading woman, Joanne Henry, Sarah Ulmer right beside her. through Merrill Drive. That's about a quarter of the race done, and these three are just breaking away.
Look at Phil Cloud, so composed, so comfortable.
All three of these guys, any one of them could take the win. Rick Wells would normally be there, but he's got a bit of a chest infection, so don't expect anything from him.
Our leading two women. And back from them a bit,
Brenda Lawson and Anna Ballara in fourth. Okay, as the leading three just bide their time to make their move, you can see they're out in front. It's a race for fifth, big bunch there. Rick Wells looks to have fourth all to himself.
The pace just starting to pick up. Where do they go? How far from the finish do they set out and say, I'm going to nail this sucker?
I had a little chat to Phil Claude before this race, and he said, when I feel good, I'm going.
All right, well, look for that little twinkle in his eye then, and hope he's talking about running.
Joanne Henry, though, beginning to clear out. She's dropped Sarah Ulmer.
Roger Gray and Mark Rendell.
A little check from Phil Claude. I think he feels good, but Phil, don't underestimate these two behind you.
Roger Gray, the policeman, pounding the pavement. But look at this, Louisa Wall and Daryl Johnson struggling.
Phil Claude is kicking away. It's Mark and Phil. Hamish is history.
Ian Ferguson and Paul Bethel from Surf Life Saving. Look at this. Daryl Johnson, that hammer you talked about, Macca.
Taxi! Taxi, end of Queen Street.
That's cruel, Simon. Check out Phil Claude. Beautiful stride, beautiful form, and so relaxed. Just what you'd expect from a sub-4-minute miler.
Somebody with flowers just ran through there.
Might be flowers for Joanne Henry. She's looking strong for the women's race. And Anna Ballara really striding out in the flat. She could challenge that first place for the woman.
Paul Henderson, the big fella, might have used up all his energy at the biathlon. Looks to be slowing down a bit.
Bad race for rugby, this one. Phil Claude, listen to his feet. Not a sound. He is just touching the ground. He is absolutely flying and takes first place. Great stuff. Mark Hutchison, athletics 1 and 2. Hamish Carter, last year's winner, back in third.
And Rick Wells, even with that chest infection, great effort, fourth spot.
Here's the race for fifth. World lightweight rower, Rob Hemmel.
Logan Edwards, seventh, and Ferguson, eighth. Trent Bray just crossing in 10th.
Look at Anna Ballara go, Joanne, here I come, look out.
Joanne Henry and Fitu Taiwa making the move there. Joanne Henry though, first woman home, another great finish for her.
And Anna Ballara grabs second. So here's how the teams finished. Athletics from triathlon, surf lifesaving, cycling, rowing, and sixth was league. They were equal with swimming, soccer was eighth, aerobics, yachting, rugby, and last was basketball netball.
Hard day. Hard day.
That was a very good finish for the athletics team.
Yeah, mate. Oh, bloody Mark, you pushed me all the way. I was thinking it was Hamish. The boy was the same colour.
Were you at any stage trying to beat Phil?
I was just trying to hang on to him, really. I don't think I've ever beaten Phil over a mile, so, you know, I don't think it was going to start today.
Well, it was the battle we talked about.
Well, no battle. A one-man race, two-man race. I wasn't in it. That's fast, eh? Oh, didn't feel too good, but good on them.
Was it faster than RCF?
It must have been. They were flying. But they're good at that sort of thing.
First woman home, as expected, Joanne.
Yeah, but Sarah and some other girls were far behind me, so I was a bit scared to look around in case I lost some ground again.
So after 3 weeks of competition, this is how the teams look. Stamina Athletics leading the way, 67 points. ECNZ Rowing, 52. Sheraton Hotels Triathlon have moved to third spot, 51 points. McDonald's Surf Lifesaving on 50. Avanti Cycling, they've had a good one, 43 points. A good week for them. And Mitsubishi Trucks League on 42 points. ANZAC New Zealand Soccer have 42 as well. Shell Rugby with 40.
Kodak Express swimming 32 points, two back from them and struggling in this series so far, Reebok Aerobics on 30. Line 7 Yachting are six back on 24, they'll need a big effort. And Smoke-Free Basketball Netball on 20 points, still some work to do.
Damn! No time for window shopping there, mate, was there? Really flat out.
Well, that was fast. Phil Claude has just smashed our Clash record by 15 seconds. Fast.
What about you personally? Any surprises that stick out?
Anna Ballara and Joanne Henry. The women's race was just superb.
Yeah, it was a biggie.
Amazing. You know, it's funny, isn't it? I was just thinking as they were coming down there, you devise all these courses and events, but I don't actually see you doing too much. Would you like to have a crack one time, maybe?
I'd love to. And Simon, I hear you've been doing a bit of training, so I'll meet you up the top in a couple of minutes. It's you and me, bucko.
At the bar, I'll see you there. Anyway, next week, Stairway to Heaven, and we hit the jet skis.
Or perhaps we should rephrase that. The jet skis hit us. It's all out on the water. But first, the ultimate stair climb once again takes its toll on our athletes.
Righto, another week over. And just quietly, as the sun descends, I'm not sure that I want to be hanging around on Queen Street in these shorts. Paul, are you with me?
I'm with you, mate. I'm out of here. See you next week.
Hooray.